Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Ricky with TechBud Solutions. I hope that you guys are all having an amazing day. In the next couple of minutes, I'm going to be talking about the top six ETFs that I see value in for this upcoming week leading up to the month of December. So I want to make sure that you guys understand three things. Never invest based on other people's opinion. Never invest in what you don't understand. And always have a plan when investing. One of the biggest best practices that we try to share and implement within TechBud Solutions and Learn Plan Profit is how important it is to manage your risk. If you're not someone that could manage your risk, then how can you grow your account if you cannot control how much money you give back? Again, my name is Ricky. I run the largest YouTube channel for those who invest in the stock market. If you guys haven't dedicated time to check it out, I have a little bit over 420,000 subscribers. I upload two videos every single day, recapping my trades, and then somewhat of a helpful video later throughout the day talking about some question or idea that people are asking me within our group chats. Again, our Facebook group is TechBud Solutions. I think it's the third or fourth link in the description. It's 100% for free. We have over 172,000 members already part of TechBud Solutions. It's the largest private Facebook group for those who invest in the stock market. Be sure to click that link if you want to join. On top of that, we have a link right here on the top pinned post that will guide you on over to our Discord chat. This is for Learn Plan Profit, but for TechBud Solutions, in which that you can have the ability to network with tens of thousands of people all across the world. Again, I did one of my recaps today. So if you watched my earlier video today, I did a recap on I actually closed one of my positions. So at that point, I was up $1,090 this morning, and then I closed my position. I think I closed this video at like $1,100 profit. I'm gonna show you guys my overall P&L in the day. So this is, I traded two ETFs today. $1,132 profit on UGAS and $73 profit on DGAS. Altogether was right a little bit above $1,200, as you guys can see right here, simply trading two ETFs. So again, let's go ahead and get right to it. I talked about ticker symbol TQQ before. So what I want you to understand is, why is it that I see value in this? Well, it's shown very consistent uptrend, right? This is a specific type of ETF that follows the NASDAQ very closely. So one thing that I've been liking about how it's performing right now is that it's starting to make higher highs, and it's showing signs of a potential reversal. I don't think it's really going to, you know, touch the SMA line, or if it's fully going to reverse. But one thing that I do or have been able to see, at least for the past, you know, 2 days, is that it has been making higher highs. It's been reacting very nicely to this SMA indicator, which is this green line that you see right here. I have a whole video on YouTube. Just search up SMA. And the really cool thing about this, it's easy to identify the low points. It's easy to identify the high points. I like the pattern. I like the direction, and I like the margin of profit. Being able to scalp it from the bottoms to highs, again, the bottoms to the highs. Overall, a little bit over 2% margin. That's not too bad for a day trade, in my opinion. And that's why I have it in my active uptrend watch list. Why is it that, again, I have it in my active watch list? So not under my pending reversal watch list, nothing like that. It's because it's currently showing signs of an uptrend. That's one of my biggest focuses for this upcoming week. So again, just solely focusing on whatever showing signs of an uptrend. Does that mean because I have in my active watch list that I have to trade it? No. But it's something that's showing signs of an uptrend, so it's something that I could review the morning of if I have nothing else to select from. One of the most common ones that I've been trading this week and last week and the week before that have been the natural gas ETFs, UGAS and DGAS, just like I did today. Today, again, I closed a little bit over $1,200. Yesterday was a little bit over $2,600. Right on Friday, I lost $760. I did a recap on my $5,400 day that I had on Friday the week before that, and then $1,400. Again, I've been doing exceptionally well, just focusing on natural gas ETFs. So I'm gonna have a huge focus on natural gas ETFs, but these are ones that I'm having as like my plan B, right? Making sure that I have a backup plan and that I have at least something in the works that is showing signs of an uptrend. So if I want to review it to see if it's something that's showing sign, you know, to potentially take a position on, then I can. So again, I'm looking at it on the 2-day, 5-minute chart, or the 5-day, 5-minute chart, to understand its overall pattern. Obviously, as where it's at right now, it wouldn't really make much sense as it's a good buy. But one thing that I really do like with the pattern that it's been showing is how it reacts to this SMA line. So as long as it bounces off this SMA line and then it begins to show signs of an uptrend with the MACD, with the RSI, and then begins to make higher highs with the overall pattern, again, I understand the pattern, I understand the direction, and then I understand that the overall margin of profit is in my favor, and it's something that I agree with. And again, that That's based on your opinion. This is ticker symbol DWT. So I'm going to look at the 180-day analysis. One thing that I want you to know about this one is that what? It's super overbought, super overextended, not a good deal. I would not swing trade this one whatsoever. Why? Because it has a lot of margin to potentially pull back down to this overall SMA line. The thing that I've been noticing is that multiple times within the week, right? So even looking at the 10-day, 30-minute chart, look how it reacts to the SMA line. How it consolidates around the SMA line and then pushes up, right? These margins aren't tiny. They're huge margins. Do you see? Look at the percentage. I don't know if you guys could see the margins when it pushes off the SMA line. It's about 15 to 20%. And again, if this pattern continues, we understand the pattern, or I understand the pattern, that's why it's in my watch list. I like the pattern. I like that it's been making higher highs. It's super overextended. Now it comes down to the general understanding that, okay, I'm gonna wait for a good deal. I'm gonna wait for the bounce, and I'm gonna wait for it to start making higher highs. Look at the MACD, look at the RSI. The MACD is not there yet. It's kind of just been consolidating. All it did today on the 2-day, 5-minute chart is low 1280s, right? 1280s to $13 were kind of the low points. And every time that it pushed above 1380, sell territory, right? Sell, right? RSI is super overbought, super overextended, not a good deal. Keeping it super simple. A lot of day trade opportunity when you understand the pattern, when you understand the direction, and when you understand that the margin of profit is worth it. And that's what I'm focusing on. Ticker symbol DRIP, almost showed an identical pattern. They follow relatively kind of close. One thing that you guys, also 180-day analysis, super overbought, super overextended. Probably wouldn't feel very comfortable swing trading this, but what I do like is how consistent it's been showing signs of an uptrend. We can go on the 20-day, 1-hour chart and see how it's been making higher highs. I like the direction. I like the pattern. And now looking at it a little bit closer, the 5-day, 5-minute chart. Now it comes down to identifying, you know, not just on the 1-day, 1-minute chart, what are the low points and what are the high points, but looking just in the past week, how has it been trading? What are good deals and what are possibly not good deals? And then also understanding the overall direction and how it's been trading. Understand the direction, understand its pattern and how it works. So if it breaks its pattern, you could cut losses or cover profits. And then most importantly, make sure that the opportunity cost altogether is worth it. Make sure that the investment is worth it. So again, giving you the example, would you buy an iPhone for $10,000? No, because it's not a good deal. Same thing when it comes down to when you see something that doesn't offer a decent enough margin of profit. If it's not a good deal and it's not worth the risk, then it's not worth the investment. And the more you say no, the better, right? The more empowerment that you will get that, hey, I'm someone that's opinionated, I'm someone that has a specific eye for value, and not everything is going to meet my criteria. This is ticker symbol UGAS. Obviously, natural gas has been absolutely killing it the past couple of weeks. And that's especially why I've been able to do so well. The volatility has been crazy. I've been able to day trade it only, right? It's been getting rejected. It's been making lower lows. But I've as of today, and I talked about it yesterday, natural gas sold off, right? But then it recovered during pre-market hours. And it's what matters is when the market's open, like where natural gas is at. So something that I watch very closely is /NG, right? I like to understand its patterns. I like to understand its direction. And right around 7:30, is especially when I started to trade it, is when it was right around, again, the same support that it had during extended hours. It reached that right around like 8 o'clock, started to make higher highs, and look at all this margin, right? The same thing followed when it came down to UGAS. It hit its overall lows right here, right around 8 o'clock. And guess what? It completed all this margin, over 10%. That's my weekly goal. And I was able to take advantage of part of that, right? So I closed a little bit over $1,100 on this specific position, overall $1,200 on the day, right? And what I focused on was the pattern, the direction, and that the opportunity cost was worth it. I'm not swing trading anything. Market's too volatile. I don't feel comfortable doing it for others that continue to ask me. It's just not something where I feel comfortable enough to leave my money invested in something because it's been so volatile, right? So on the 20-day, 1-hour chart, one thing that you do want to take into consideration, actually the 180-day hour chart, it's the EMA line is acting as a resistance as of right now. It's not showing signs of an uptrend. And you can see that with the MACD as well. It's trying to recover, but we don't know if it's going to as of right now. So that's why I have all these different alerts set up, and that's why I follow it on a very close basis. So I'll follow up with it just like I do every single morning at around 5 to 6 a.m., and I'll probably trade during pre-market hours if the opportunity cost is worth it, just like I did today. I was up over $550 for those that follow me on Instagram before the market even opened, all during pre-market hours. Ticker symbol LABU. I'm sorry, LABD. LABD has been showing signs of a pretty consistent uptrend pattern. Look at the MACD, look at the RSI. Already showing signs of a potential reversal pattern. Same thing with the RSI, but it became a little bit more on the overbought side. It definitely pushed up again. What we want to see is for this thing to continue to uptrend. So for the rally to continue, for it to continue to make higher highs. That's why you see my alert there, and that's why I'm going to follow up with it and see if that rally continues. On the 1 day, 1 minute chart, you could try to see the low points and the high points and take advantage of that if it's something that you see valid in. But most importantly, one thing I'm just gonna revisit is its direction, and then look a little bit closer on the timeframes and see if it's actually beginning to make higher highs. That's really just it. It was selling off, and as you could see on the 180 day chart, you could see that it was selling off, right? It was making lower lows, it was making lower highs, and it wasn't until today that it pushed up. 1 day is not a confirmation. It needs to continue to show that flow of pattern. So that's why we set that alert there, and we'll simply follow up with it. If it pushes up, great. It's something that we could have in our active watch list. If it pulls back, then guess what? I will remove it from my watch list because it's selling off, and I will add LABU, which is the inverse ETF of LABD. The last one I'm gonna talk about is ticker symbol JDST. Why am I going to be talking about this one? This one has been showing signs of an uptrend. Again, I follow /GC to have a better understanding of, you know, where it's going to be going. Recently, it got rejected by this overall SMA line. So when /GC sells off, then that means that JDST will push up, correct? So I will follow during pre-market hours, during extended hours, right? And see if this thing continues to sell off. If this overall, I mean, do you guys see how this flow, kind of how it goes, right? Kind of builds like this little like hill. Same thing with this. It makes sense on why it can continue to sell off. It doesn't mean that it has to, it just means that it can. So I'm gonna wait for that confirmation. Most important thing, don't take advantage of an opportunity if you have no confirmation. And as of right now, yes, I have the idea that the pattern is showing signs of lower lows and lower highs, which is in favor of JDST that can drive the price up, but I have no confirmation yet. And again, I'm not gonna be holding it overnight and wishing and hoping for the best. I'm gonna wait for that confirmation, take advantage of that opportunity, and see if those higher highs are made, and that's why it's in my watch list. It absolutely killed it today. It stayed in between the middle and top VWAP, perfect textbook pattern, and then gets rejected at top VWAP, being able to buy the low, sell the peaks, buy the low, sell the peaks, buy the low, sell the peaks, super, super simple. And it cleared over 5% today. So for all those that have a goal on a weekly basis of 2-3%, then guess what? This could be something that you might want to watch, or if it gets rejected, then again, for a day trade opportunity, maybe it's inverse ETF, which is ticker symbol JNUG. And again, I use the future /GC for JDST, which is a gold-based ETF. For LABD, if I'm not mistaken, I use /CL. For UGAS, I use /NG. For DRIP, I use /CL. I don't use indexes, so I know a lot of people are gonna be throwing that other index that everyone loves to talk about. I don't use it. And then DWT, I use /CL, if I'm not mistaken. And then TQQQ, I use /NQ. So where am I at? 12 minutes. Okay. 12 minutes through this live stream. Alrighty. I actually thought I was going to be able to do this in 8 minutes. It sounds like I don't speak quick enough. What happened? Are we all good? But yeah. What's going on? Wait, am I not live? I'm live, right? I'm good? Okay, I'm not too sure what's going on. I don't really understand. Okay, I'm just gonna close out the live stream, but I really do appreciate you guys tuning in. Thank you guys again so much for your time. Okay. I'm so confused right now. It shows that I'm live, but yeah. Okay. I'm beyond confused right now. So all the links are down below to stay connected. Thank you guys again for your time. Wish you guys all an amazing rest of your day. Like always, let's make sure that we end the year on green out. Take it easy, team. Test, 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 1, 2, 1, 2. I'm gonna make sure that this live stream is live before I continue. Let's see. Nope, doesn't look live. goodness. Test, test, test. 1, 2, 3. Just gonna test out to see if the actual stream is live. Let's check it out. 1, 2, 3. All right, just gonna check it.